Hi, I'm Raksha, and today I'm in Bukhara, the ancient city of Bukhara. I'm happy that I'm here in Bukhara because finally, after Tashkent and Samarkand, I finally feel like I'm in an ancient city like Bukhara, where I can actually imagine traders trading their wares here. And you, when you walk around the old town, you get that kind of vibe, you know. I feel that that was missing in Samarkand and Tashkent. Going out exploring some places here in Bukhara. I arrived in Bukhara in the middle of summer, but I wasn't ready for what I was about to experience.
Only if you could feel the hot air brushing against your ear, against your skin, you would realize how hot this place is. I cannot believe it. It's 7 p.m. Sun is about to set and it's so hot. Bollywood, Shah Rukh Khan.
So madrassahs were actually a center of learning. Students learned different subjects here in these madrassahs. And so these are where the classrooms were, the lower floors, and the upper floors were where the students lived.
Directly facing Ulugbek Madrasa is the breathtaking Abdul Aziz Khan Madrasa, an epitome of medieval Central Asian architecture.
Even though it's like so hot, I actually like this place. It's so nice to walk in an open-air museum of a town and be able to actually spend as much time as you want, or as little as you want. You can actually stop and admire and come back here again without having to pay for another entrance ticket. You can take it at your own pace. I think that's really nice.
What makes Bukhara so special for me isn't one of its buildings, but the overall townscape that transports you back in time. The historic center of Bukhara is a UNESCO World Heritage Site and is known as a living museum. Just keep walking in the old town and you will chance upon something historically significant, like this trading dome, which is said to be active since the times of the Silk Road. This is one of the four trading domes that has survived to this day. You will be spoiled with options here. You'll find a wide range of products from inexpensive knickknacks to thousands of dollars of silk carpets. Whatever your budget is, I'm sure you'll find something in Bukhara. Now entering another trading dome.
You definitely see a lot more souvenirs here, and I think that's because there are a lot of masters, like skilled workers from different places who have settled here, like masters who are skilled in miniature painting and carpets and blacksmith work. So you see so many souvenir shops here. It's crazy. It's like heaven if you want to shop, really. India.
Oh, nice. New Delhi, Bombay.
Bangalore, south of India. Yeah. What about you? Where are
Bukhara.
You? Bukhara.
Yes,
okay.
Yes.
Uzbek.
Uzbek.
Oh, okay.
Nice.
Didn't I tell you, there's so much talent here everywhere you look.
Persia, Kabul, India, China, Bukhara, Khiva, Samarkand, Bukhara, Khiva, Venice. He's Marco Polo from Venice.
Oh.
He's Ibn Battuta, Arabian traveler from Morocco.
Wow. Thank you. For those of you asking how safe Uzbekistan is, you'll see like tourist booths like these everywhere in the major ancient Silk Road cities. And it's basically for tourist safety purposes. So I would say definitely, no doubt about it, Uzbekistan is like the most tourist-friendly destination of Central Asia.
I reached Kalon Minaret just in time and it was all lit up, and what a fascinating sight. This tower so impressed Genghis Khan that he ordered it to be spared when all around was destroyed by his men. This is also known as the Tower of Death because for several centuries criminals were tossed from the top and thus executed. What a delicious breakfast spread. Samsa in tandoor with pumpkin pie, bread with homemade jam, biscuits with cream, and of course the ubiquitous Uzbek tea. My host was so excited to watch the videos on my YouTube channel, he even subscribed.
Very funny, very good.
But you know what hurts? 98% of you haven't subscribed. Subscribe to my channel now. Maybe it's the right time.
Yesterday at 7 p.m., it was 40 degrees Celsius. Now it's much cooler because, you know, because of the night. And it's so much pleasant actually walking in the morning, honestly. So empty too.
I booked a Yandex taxi to the Yark of Bukhara. It's about 1.5 kilometers from the old town and easily walkable, but since I had limited time to explore Bukhara, it made sense to take a cab to save as much time as possible.
Rehmat.
The Ark of Bukhara is a massive fortress that was initially built and occupied around the 5th century. It's pretty much like a city within a city and is one of Bukhara's most iconic structures. Next stop, Bolohoz Mosque. The unique feature of this mosque is the long pillars that line the front entrance. This mosque is also known as the 40-pillar mosque because its ceiling is held by 20 wooden pillars that reflect in the pond in front of the building. So in total, you see 40 pillars.
Now I'm on the way to the home of a portrait artist. Hi, Ivan. He's originally from Russia, now currently in Bukhara, and he's a portrait artist and he wants to make a portrait of me. So he's just setting it up.
Thank you.
Hi, Ivan. Thank you so much for making my portrait. It's so beautiful. You're so talented.
Thank you for posing. You're so talented.
It's so easy to pose. Whatever you did was really hard. So posing was the easiest part.
I hope we will repeat it someday.
Yes, definitely. And thank you. Now when I see it, it's so empty. I think it's because of the weather. And you will see in just like an hour from now, this place will be bustling with activities, with, you know, shopkeepers selling their wares and people sitting outside drinking, chatting, and this whole ancient city will come alive. After a few sweltering hot days in Bukhara, I knew I couldn't continue my travels in Uzbekistan and I decided to come back here at a later time. Now I would head to Samarkand, from where I would be crossing the border to Tajikistan, my second Central Asian country, where I plan to spend some time in the mountains. More than anything, I was excited to go back to Samarkand in the fastest train in Uzbekistan, Afrosiyob. But unfortunately, I got late and I ended up missing the train. It was so disappointing. I really need to start making better decisions. Just like life, travel has different sides to it. Some are scenic and others aren't. I'll talk about everything you need to know about traveling to Uzbekistan in the next video so that you don't make the same mistakes as I did. Don't forget to like this video if you enjoyed watching it, and I'll see you in the next video.